Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is me, your host Prajwal, and today I'm going to show you how to use hop.exchange or the hop protocol, and also we'll talk about a potential hop protocol airdrop. So let's get started. Before we start, please make sure you understand none of the things mentioned in this video is or should be taken as a financial advice. These airdrops are not guaranteed, and this is purely speculation at this point, and I do not guarantee that you would get an airdrop by following the steps mentioned in this video. This is for educational purpose and something that I like to share and something that I've learned which might be helpful for some users or anyone subscribed to the channel. And as always, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up and show your support. That helps out the channel a lot. And if you'd like to learn more about crypto and would like to get notified every time I publish a guide or anything related to crypto, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon. Before I get into video, I just forgot to mention that all the transactions that I do in this guide moving forward requires Matic. So if you don't have any Matic, it doesn't require a lot. I had 0.9 Matic, which was enough for all the transactions that I've done in the video. So keep that in mind if I don't mention. I do have 0.9 Matic in that wallet already for me to do transactions that I do in this video. I use USDC, but if you just want to use Matic and if you don't have any Matic in your wallet already, maybe you want to just transfer a bit more Matic and then use Matic as an asset to transfer and to use the protocol, right? If you have any confusion, if you have any question, just make sure you leave in comments. I'll try my best to reply to that. So first, what is hop protocol or hop.exchange? Okay, if you are familiar with what a bridge is, it's a sort of a similar thing. What it allows you to do is basically from your ETH mainnet, you can transfer funds back and forth to other layer two. For example, you can send different assets, for example, Matic, USDT, Tether, USDC coin, DAI, or the main ETH, to different networks such as Polygon mainnet. Mainnet is your ETH mainnet, the basic layer one Ethereum, XDAI, Optimism, or Arbitrum. So back and forth. So if you have watched my guide on how to use Optimism and how to transfer funds to Optimism in the past, so you can use hop.exchange directly to transfer the funds from the mainnet to Optimism, and you can just select ETH and you can transfer, you can do those transfers as well and possibly being eligible for an Optimism airdrop as well. And again, no guaranteed, but that's what I've done. And if you would like to know how to do that, there'll be a video on the top right corner or in the description. So how to use hop.exchange? So I'm going to show you a couple of things today. I'm going to show you how to transfer the funds from one network to another. And also I'll show you how you can provide liquidity and earn a little bit of rewards while you're waiting for the possible hop.exchange airdrop as well. So I'm not going to use ETH. I'm going to use USDC. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to transfer USDC to my wallet. You can use any centralized exchange or decentralized exchange to purchase any of the funds. For the purpose of this video, like I said, I'm going to use USDC. So I'm going to transfer some USDC to my wallet. So I'm going to copy my wallet address and paste that here. And I'm going to select the Matic network. So it's showing me one USDC fee and 3 minutes arrival time. That's fine. It'll probably take a few minutes for the USDC to arrive in my wallet. And as you can see, I've received my USDC. So if you don't see it, what you need to do is you need to change the asset, right? So depending on what you are sending, you can send XDAI, you can send ETH. If you already have some ETH, you can do those transfers if you like. USDC, Matic, whatever you like, right? So I've used USDC because it's easier to provide the liquidity later on. So it's up to you, right? As always, do your own research and make decisions based on your own research. Now, what I can do is I can send this USDC back to the mainnet, example, the main ETH layer one, or I can send it to XDAI, Optimism, or Arbitrum as well. So for example, if I want to send at the moment, it is on Polygon. On the Polygon, I have 499. And if I would like to send some USDC on Optimism to use applications on Optimism, I can go ahead, select Optimism there, and put the amount that I would like to send. For example, if I want to send $100 USDC, as you can see, it's showing me $5.85 USDC, right? So now after that, you've sent it through, after you've approved, this can be a bit less as well. So that's just an estimate. And one of the cool things what you can do is if you like to send, so now this is sending to the same wallet, right? So for example, if you have a second wallet or if you have other wallets that you use, you can also go to options and you can paste the wallet address that you would like to withdraw to. For example, you have another wallet that you would like to use on Optimism that is not the one that's currently connected. What you can do is you can copy that other wallet address, paste it here, and send it through to Optimism. Now, that's true for Optimism, that's true for Arbitrum, that's true for all the networks. So, meaning from one wallet, you can withdraw directly to another wallet that is not the one that's connected. I hope that was clear. If that is not clear, please let me know in the comments and I can probably clear things out for you. So for the first time, you'll have to approve. That will probably cost you some gas fees. For example, at the moment, it's $0. Which is 0.001974. That is because I'm on Matic network or the Polygon network. So if you are on ETH mainnet, that will probably cost you a bit more. So I'm going to confirm that. You will only need to approve it the first time that you're using. So it's a sort of providing approval or you sort of to use these assets on your wallet. That will be the same for example, if you go transfer USDT for the first time, Matic for the first time, or DAI for the first time. It will be the same. It has to be approved. So the next time you use Polygon network on this wallet to send USDC to any of this layer 2 or layer 1 mainnet, you don't have to approve it anymore. You can just send it through. So after you've approved USDC, go ahead and send it. And as you can see, it says send USDC from Polygon Optimism, estimate received, and click on send. I'm not going to send it through now, but you can just click on send and you just need to approve it on your MetaMask and it will go through. For the airdrop, what I've done is I have a couple of wallets. So I have just used one wallet to withdraw it to other wallets, Optimism and Arbitrum. And I've used Optimism and I've used Uniswap on Optimism and just back and forth and stuff like that. So if you would like to learn how to use Uniswap on Optimism or Arbitrum, the tutorial will be in the description or on the top right corner from the cards. You can just access those videos. Now, how to provide liquidity. So for providing liquidity, you will receive some liquidity pool tokens, which you can go and stake as well, right? So this can be a bit overwhelming for a beginner or someone who's just starting out. So you would need USDC and HUSDC. So you need to convert a little bit of your USDC to HUSDC and add both of them into the liquidity pool. At the moment, as you can see, I have 499 USDC, but I don't have any HUSDC, right? So what I'm going to do first, I need to convert a little bit of USDC to HUSDC. So go to convert Polygon. I have my USDC on Polygon. I'm going to select the asset. And if you have some assets, whatever you are trying to provide liquidity for on your mainnet, for example, you can use your hop bridge. On the mainnet, I only have 10 USDC, so I'm going to use via AMM, which is Automated Market Maker. And I'm going to convert 100 USDC to 100 HUSDC, which will be 99.84. So what I'm going to do is 101 and approve. As I said, every first transaction you make, or the first kind of transaction you make, has to be approved. Approve that. And as you can see, it says approve all. So I'm going to go confirm. All right, so it has been approved. It took about 5 minutes for the approval. So just sit tight if you are waiting for the approval. Once it's approved, you will probably need to refresh your page. So I refreshed it. It was still asking me to approve. So I refreshed it, waited for a few minutes, and then I saw the convert button. So click on convert again, and send the transaction through. Confirm. All right, as you can see, I have 100 HUSDC. So what I'm gonna go is pool. I'm gonna select USDC. I'm gonna select Polygon. Like I said, you can select any assets, whatever you wanna provide liquidity to. I'm gonna go USDC, 100 HUSDC, and 100 USDC. Click on add liquidity. Approve, confirm. Once the task is approved, click on add liquidity. I'm adding 100 USDC and 100 HUSDC. Click on add liquidity and confirm that again and give it some time. It will probably take a couple of minutes. And as you can see, my position is 194.971, pool share of less than 1%, that's fine, 111 HUSD. And for example, if you use Matic as an asset, first you'll have to wrap your Matic here, right? For example, I only have 0.18 Matic, but if you transfer, for example, let's say you have 100 Matic and you would like to provide liquidity, what you need to do first is you need to convert your Matic to wrapped Matic. So for example, if I have 100, I'll probably go 20 Matic, wrap it, and then you'll have to also convert some Matic to H Matic. So go to convert, Polygon, Matic, and then transfer that to H Matic, and then add the liquidity like that, right? So those are a couple of things. And if you are providing liquidity for Matic, you can go and stake those tokens. So after you've done and you've added liquidity using Matic, not USDC, because USDC rewards have already ended, as you can see here. If you have provided liquidity for Matic, you can come back here and then stake those liquidity pool tokens as well, which will earn you a bit more fees and a bit more money as time goes on, right? So now talking about the airdrop, it is not guaranteed, but the speculation is very high and a lot of reputable people are talking about a possible hop.exchange or the hop protocol airdrop, as they don't have a token yet and it only makes sense for them to have a token with a really nice use case. Another thing is, if you have used Optimism or Arbitrum in the past to bridge your assets from layer 1 to layer 2, you can use hop protocol to withdraw it to layer 1. For example, on Optimism or Arbitrum, it takes about 7 days to withdraw funds. But on hop.exchange, it probably takes about 5 or 10 minutes. Example, if you withdraw funds from Optimism to ETH mainnet layer 1, there's 67 days wait period. But if you use hop protocol, you don't have to wait that long. So I thought I'd just mention that as well. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. Any suggestions for any videos or the channel, also leave them in the comments. As always, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up, as that helps out a lot. And subscribe and hit the bell icon for more guides like this. Thank you, and you have a nice day.